गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, गुड
गुड
इवनिंग।
इवनिंग सर। बस
यस, हाउ आर यू ऑल? गुड
सर,
वेरी गुड। सो लास्ट क्लास, सो हाउ इज योर प्रिपरेशन गोइंग ऑन एवरीवन? द स्टूडेंट्स हु डिड नॉट फिनिश द एग्जाम, हाउ इज योर प्रिपरेशन गोइंग ऑन? How's your preparation going on? Anudeep, finish your math exam. Hello, guys, can you hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
When is your math exam, Anudeep? Anudeep, you was present, like you was absent, right? The last class. I think Anudeep was absent for the last class. Know why he has some problem not responding.
So can we revise coordinate geometry once?
Yeah, definitely. But circles, once we're done with the circles, we'll go with that.
Yes, I was asking because this is a chapter of term one and it's coming up soon. That's why.
Okay, that is for your exam syllabus. Okay, that
Yes,
is
sir,
coming
for
for
term one exams, it's in term.
definitely. Yes, we'll revise that. So basically, everyone look at this here. Guys, how many of you have coordinate geometry in your exam? For your exam, how many of you are having coordinate geometry?
Sir, sir, for mock test, sir.
For yes, so whatever the exam is going to, you are going to
Sir,
write in your school
today
side.
morning, yes, sir. Today morning we had our maths exam in the school, so we did coordinate geometry there.
Okay. So what about others?
Yes, sir. In coordinate geometry, sir, 7.1 and 7.2 is coming up.
Okay. What about girls?
Actually, sir, this Monday is my exam.
Prathiva, Pratyusha, have you done with your exam? Pratyusha, they are not here. Amrita has done with her exam. Akhil, what about Akhil and Akhil and Ahil, whether are you guys going to get? Yes, I think technical, I mean, internet issue from my side. Yes, we'll talk about coordinate geometry. Look at this in coordinate geometry. What basically what you have? Let me revise you. That's it. Okay. So basically, what happens? This is my x-axis. This is my y-axis. This is what called as what Cartesian plane? Yes or no? This is what called as my Cartesian plane. Hello?
They are not present.
I'm presenting the screen.
Okay, now we can.
Yes. So wherever you have x coordinate, I mean x axis and y axis, that particular plane is called as Cartesian plane. So in Cartesian plane, what will happen? So I'll be plotting a point here. Let us say this is my point P, which is x comma y. What is x here? X is called as x coordinate, y is called as y coordinate. Or you say और यू से ये कम अभी व्हाट इज ये हियर एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट वाई बी इज व्हाट वाई कोऑर्डिनेट एज सिंपल एज दैट सो हियर ये कम अभी राइट सो हियर एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज ए वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज बी ए इज कॉल्ड एज एब्सिसा एंड बी इज कॉल्ड एज ऑर्डिनेट Everyone knows this. Yes or no? Very simple concept. Yes or no? Yes. Now after this we have learned. Yes, after this we have learned. As soon as we introduced, as soon as we learned, the, I mean like plotting the points on coordinate axis in a Cartesian plane, we learned, we also have seen distance formula. What is the distance between two points formula? Distance between two points. What is the formula? So let us say I have two points. This is my Cartesian plane. I have two points. Let us say here, koi line le lo. This is point P. Let us say this is point Q. Okay. So now it is in plane, right? So this has some distance. This also some distance. All right, so it is a perpendicular now. Yes or no? It's a point. Let us say, koi point le lo. I'm taking this as point A, x1 comma y1. I'm taking this as point B, x2 comma y2. Okay. So now, what is this length is going to be? This is x1 distance. This is x2 distance. Yes or no? Or else look at this boys. You tell me what is this distance here? X1. What is this distance here? X2. Now what is this distance is going to be? X2 minus X1. Yes or no? Yes or no? Clear? Hello?
Yes sir. Yes, sir.
Now here what is this distance? Y1. What is this distance? Y2. So then what is this distance is going to be? Y2 minus Y1. Yes or no? Clear? Now I have to find what?
Yes.
What I have to find out now? So which means like, now I know this one. I know this length and this length. So this length is Y2 minus Y1. This length is X2 minus X1. So I have to find a hypotenuse. Can't I use Pythagoras theorem and you find it out now? So from... let us say ye kuch bhi le lo let us say c from triangle abc by using so ab square is equal to What is AB square? I have to find out AB square here. I have to find out AB value, which is distance between two points. I have point A and point B. I have to find a distance between these two points. Guys, are you listening to the class?
Yes, sir.
Huh. So, look at this here. So, AC square. What is AC square now? What is AC? X2 minus X1. What is BC here? Y2 minus... Y1 whole square. Expand this. AB square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2 times of AB plus A square or A square plus B square minus 2 times of Y1, Y2. All right.
Yes, sir.
Or else simply can I say, guys, why do we need to expand this? No need of expanding. I need AB here. AB is equal to what? This is my formula. X2 minus X1 whole square plus this is a proof here. Any doubts? Any doubts? Hello? Any doubts?
No.
Very simple. Now after this, we learn sectional formula. What is the sectional formula? Guys, whatever you are learning now, everything you are going to learn 11th standard. In 11th standard, you will get a chapter called straight lines. In straight lines, again, you will revise everything. What is coordinates? How do you plot a point on the x-axis and y-axis? I mean, in Cartesian plane. And what is the distance formula? What is, sectional formula? What is internal divide, external divide, midpoint? Everything you will be learning again over there. But based upon this concept only, you will be having a straight lines chapter. So listen to me carefully now. So in sectional formula, what we have learned, guys? Tell me. I don't want to teach like every proof now. Just we have like in this we are going to learn internal divide. External divide and midpoint formula. All right. Midpoint formula. So basically, look at this here. For internal divide, what you'll be having, look at how will you dividing? Let us say I have PQ line. I'm dividing, here R is dividing PQ in the ratio called M is to N. Then what will the formula for internal divide? M X2 plus N X1 divided by M plus N comma M Y2 plus M Y N Y1. Similarly for external divide, that's the same thing, but you will be having minus. And guys, midpoint is a case of what? Midpoint is a case of internal divide only. What is the formula?
The x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2.
Very simple.
Midpoint.
How do you get, look at this here? External. Internal divide means what? R is dividing line called PQ in the ratio of M by N. M by N. M is to N. So this is the formula for that. So now, just a minute, sir. Yes. Now look at this here. I have PQ line. Now look at this. Here, similarly, external divide. I have a line called PQ dividing R externally. I have PQ line. R is dividing in the ratio of externally. So what is, look at this here. Here M is to N ratio. So what is the formula? This is the formula. Midpoint formula is what? That is the internal case only. Midpoint means what? I have a PQ line dividing point R in the ratio of M is to N. Midpoint. Midpoint means it is in the middle. Middle, right? So this part will be equal to this part. Both will be equal. So here M. There is a technical issue from my side. So internal divide means what? MX2 plus NX1 divided by M plus N. m y 2 plus m y divided by m plus n. So midpoint formula is what it is, sir? Internal divide case. So it will be dividing in the ratio of 1 is to 1. So in place of m, you substitute 1. In place of n, you substitute 1. So you get this formula. Very simple. Any doubts? Any doubts?
No, sir. No doubts.
No doubts, sir.
Yes. So we have learned this now. So after this, what you have learned? Point of. After this, what you have learned apart from this? Centroid of a triangle. What is centroid of a triangle? Tell me. What is the formula? Hello?
Yes, sir.
What is the formula for centroid of a triangle? You must tell. Hello?
Sir?
Centroid of
the triangles part is deleted, right? From term one.
Okay, from the coordinates geometry, you don't have this?
Yes, sir. Coordinate geometry area of a triangle is deleted.
Yes, concept of coordinate geometry, graphs of linear equations, distance formula, sectional formula, only internal division. So this is what we have. Shut up. We have just revised everything. So if you want me to solve the questions, we will solve the questions, or else we'll go with the circles. So shall we solve a couple of questions? Or you just...
Yes, sir, we'll solve.
Okay. Okay, all right. I'll give a couple of questions to you all. The points given, -1, -2, 1, 0, -1, -2, -3, 0. Forms a quadrilateral of type. Option A. Parallelogram. Tell me, make it fast. Make it fast.
Sir, is it a square?
You are right. How to find?
Sir, it's a square.
A, B, C, D.
Sir,
given.
Can I?
Yes, A, B, C, D given.
So we need to find
distance.
A, B, B,
yes,
C,
find
D, C,
A, B,
and
C, A, C, C, D, and A, C. If all lengths are equal, then there is a square.
Yes.
And you find diagonals.
Then, sir, also diagonals should bisect each other.
And if you find AC and BD are equal, then that is a.
It can also be a rhombus, so we should check diagonal also.
Yes.
Sir, I think I found since this question was quite easy, I decided to try drawing it on the Cartesian plane. And it came out as a clear circle to me. That's how I answered it. I didn't actually solve the thing.
Okay, that is also, but you need a graph for that. You can't decide, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
You can't decide roughly, but you know, options are like very similar here. Square, it can be, you know, if you draw normally like this, if you get like this also, I won't be able to decide whether it's a square or rectangle. If you have a graph, then we can measure the distance, we can, you know, calculate the, you know, units, and we can just decide which kind of, you know, quadrilateral you are getting for. So then I could decide, but you know, normal page you can't decide actually. You have to calculate. Okay. So why can't it be rhombus? Tell me, Anandip.
So we have to use the distance formula of taking two at a time, and then we have to take the diagonals as well.
Yeah, why can't it be rhombus? Why can it be only square?
Because the diagonals are equal in a square, but in a rhombus, the diagonals are not equal.
Yes. So in rhombus, diagonals would be not equal. One second. This is my rhombus. Look at this. Rectangle. Sorry, parallelogram. This is my rhombus. Now, the diagonals of rhombus intersect at right equal angles. Yes or no? This will intersect at equal angles. Guys, can you see whatever I'm writing here?
No, sir.
So I think what you are drawing got stuck.
Yes, sir.
So the diagonals of a rhombus, bisect each other at right angles. While the diagonals of a rectangle or equal, but they're not, you know, rhombus. So that is a proof. That is a, you know, thing we can decide. Here the answer is what?
Sir, did you draw?
I drawn rhombus, I erased. So what I'm trying to say here is, look at this. The diagonals of rhombus will not be equal. This will bisect at equal angles. That is a property. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So the answer is square. Next. Next question. The distance between the points A, 2 comma minus 2, and B, minus 1 comma x, is equal to 5. In the value of x, make it fast. Make it fast. Guys, make it fast. Guys, what is the answer for this question? Tell me, what is the answer for this question? Hello? Can you hear me, children? Hello?
Yes, sir.
What is the answer?
Sir, is the distance of point A, 2,4 from x-axis is 2 units?
One second. Let me write this question. Solve remaining questions. Solve remaining questions. Let me...
Sir, for the first
So tell me here, what is the first question answer? Hello, what is the value of x here? Guys, what is the value of x?
Hello?
What is the value of x? Make it first, what is the value of x? What is the value of x? Make it fast. What is the value of x? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear my voice? What is the answer of this question? Hello?
Yes, sir.
What is the answer? Didn't you solve? What is the answer of this question? I'm asking. Long time. The distance between the point, this and this, is this much. What is the value of x? Hello?
Sir, can you solve it once? I got stuck at under the root. It's been quite some time since I revised this chapter.
Look at this here. So distance between the point A and B is what? Distance between points. So x2 minus x1. x2 is what? Minus 1. x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square is equal to 5 given. Yes or no? I have to just... distance between this, how much here? 5 given. So look at this here, 9 plus x square plus 4 plus 4x is equal to square root is equal to 5. So squaring on both sides, if I do squaring on both sides, 9 plus, so what do you get here? X square plus 4x plus 13 is equal to 25. X square plus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0. X square, so 6 into x minus 2x minus 12 is equal to 0. X common, so minus 2 common. Yes or no? So x is equal to 2 is the answer. Distance x cannot be minus 6, right? So x is a 2 is the answer. Yes or no? Any doubts? Hello.
No,
x is equal to 2 is the answer. Minus 6 not possible since distance cannot be negative. Yes or no? Distance value cannot be negative. That is the reason x is value 2. Next. Solve this question. the midpoints of a line segment joining two points, this one and this one. Diksha, you were saying some answer. What was that?
Sir, I was actually telling the answer for the second question. The next one.
You, this one?
Yeah, the midpoints of a line segment.
Okay, what is the answer?
I got the answer as C.
Okay, so what is the midpoint formula? Diksha.
X1 plus X2 by Y, comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2.
X1 plus X2 by 2, Y1 plus Y2 by 2. Okay, so what is X1, Y1 here? So X1, Y1, X2, Y2. So X1 plus X2, minus 2 plus 2 by 2. So minus 4 plus 4 by 2. So 0 comma 0, very simple. Very simple, guys. Yes or no? Any doubts? Guys, it can't be in square bracket. It should be open bracket. We'll be writing coordinates in open brackets, not square bracket. So write in open bracket. Guys, this is open bracket. This is square bracket. You cannot use this bracket. Use this bracket. Okay. Yes. Next question. The distance of a point A. The distance of a point A from the x-axis is what? Look at this. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. Distance of a point A. I have somewhere point here A. So from the x-axis, what is the answer?
Sir, it will be 4 units.
From the x-axis, look at it, sir. 2 comma 4. 2 comma 4 will be where? Somewhere here. X 2 comma 4, it will be here. Here 4, here 2. So 2 comma 4. From the x-axis, from this x-axis, what is this distance? How much? Guys, 2 comma 4 is here. From x-axis, what is this distance? 4 units. So it can't be minus 2, it can't be minus 4, it can't be 2 units. Obviously 4 units. Yes or no? Next question. Guys, are you able to follow the class? Everyone. Sira, Yogesh, Ahil, Akil. I need a response from your side. Tanvi, Tushar. I need a response from you guys. Tanvi ji, don't respond. Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No,
any
sir.
Doubts? Very good. Next, this question. Solve,
no
this,
doubt, sir.
Solve this question. So he has given that origin O is equal to A by 3 comma 4 is the midpoint of the line segment joining the points P and Q. Then the value of A is equal to what?
I got B. A is equal to minus 12.
Minus 12 is the right answer. How many of you did this? Look at what he has given. O is the midpoint of the line segment. P given minus 6 comma 5. Q given minus 2 comma 3. R given. Sorry, here O. O is A by 3 comma 4 given. So internal divide. This is internal divide or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Or else you say that?
Or we can just use the formula X1 plus X2 by 2. And then equate that with A by 3 comma 4.
This is equal to this. You can say
there your voice is low.
Sorry? Is a midpoint, right? Midpoint formula is what?
Sir, your voice is breaking, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now can you hear my voice clearly? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now how can I use, what formula I can use here? What formula you can use? Guys, so which
means x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2 is equal to the value, the points of O.
Midpoint is equal to what? A by 3 comma 4. Yes or no? So what is x1? Minus 6 minus 2 by 2. Y1 5 plus 3 by 8, so minus 4, so here 4 is equal to a by 3, comma 4. How can you compare here? Abscissa is equal to abscissa. Ordinate is equal to ordinate. So minus 4 is equal to a by 3. 4 is equal to 4, which means a is equal to minus 12. I need to find a value, right? So a value is minus 12. Clear? Hello, any doubts? Next question, guys. The point which divides the line segment of points P minus 1,7 and 4,-3 in the ratio of 2:3 is equal to dash.
There, for the first one, I got 1,3.
For the first one, what you got? 1,3. 1,3 is the right answer.
Yes, sir.
So look at this here. The point which divides the line segment P is in the ratio what? Some point here, let us say R, dividing 2:3 ratio. Which formula? So how do I need to conclude whether it is internal divide or external divide? Tell me. Guys.
Can you repeat your question, sir? Your voice is breaking.
Sorry? For the first one,
your
one.
Voice was breaking. Can you? Yes, sir.
I'm just talking that. I'm asking you that. How can you decide whether it's internal or external?
Sir, if no criteria is given, I've been told to take internally.
Exactly. If any criteria given, then you have to choose that particular. So internal divide, formula what?
M1 x2 plus m2 x1 by m1 plus m2 comma m1 y2 plus m2 y1 by m plus m1 plus m. Sir, it should be, yeah, n.
So 2 is to 3 m values, 2 n values, 3. Substitute here. So you will get, what do you get? 1 comma 3. I hope it is clear with everyone. Any doubts? Any doubts? Hello? Next question. The ratio in which the line segment, the ratio in which the line segment joining the points, this one and this one divided by this much. The ratio in which the line segment joining the points make it fast. I'll write one more question. You keep trying that.
For the question, I got C, 2 is to 7.
How?
Sir, I used again the internal formula. This time I just, in the place of M1 and M2, or M and N, I just put the variables and I equated it with the given point. And then I, you know, equated abscissa with abscissa and
the ratio
with coordinate.
Yes. So make it fast. Solve this next question. Make it fast. Solve the next one. Make it fast. The ratio.
Sir, what's the value of Q? 1,4.
Yes, 1,4. So the ordinates, look at this, what he has given. The ratio in which the line segment joining the point, this one, dividing the ratio. Yes, divided by m by n given. So is simple. You have to find out ratio now. M and n value, you have to find out equate. How to equate? Look at this. Is equal to -1,6 given. So solve this, substitute x1, y1, x2, y2 values, you will get m is to n ratio. What was the answer? 2 is to 7, right? What you got? Shut up.
Yes, sir. 2 is to 7.
2 is to 7 you got. Okay. Next question. For this, the coordinates of a point P where PQ is the diameter of a circle. Diameter of a circle. So not, I'm taking radius, sorry. Sorry. Are yaar kya ho raha hai, 1 minute. हाँ, This is what my P Q is the diameter of a circle whose center is 2, -3 given. Q point is given 1, 4. Oh, oh, oh. 1 second. Q given 1, 4. We have to find out P here. So let us say x1, y1. Let P is equal to x1, y1. Okay. So now look at this here. I need to find out here PQ. Let us say this is my center O. So here PO is equal to OQ. Distance between PO and is equal to distance between OQ. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes, sir. Both are, yes, radius, sir. Guys. This is a radius, and this is also a radius. Both will be equal, right? So PO, what is the distance between PO now? x2 - x1. So -3 - y1² + 2 - x1² is equal to square root of OQ. So y2 - y1² + x2 - x2². So again, if I do squaring on both sides, what you get? Both squares will be getting cancelled. So a - b² or else you take minus common here, 3 +
sir, instead of all these, can't we simply do a midpoint formula?
Exactly, you can do that, not an issue at all. That is also correct. That is a method one. Very good approach. Absolutely, you can do that. Look at this here. So you can do it. Actually, you can do it without any doubt. So here 7² = 49 + 1 = 50. So look at this here, -². So a² + b² + 6y1 + 4 + x1² = 4x1 = 50. -13 = 37. So this is what I got here. Now whichever the point is getting satisfied, that is your answer. So you have to verify the options. There is a longest method, as you know, Amrita said, we'll go for that midpoint formula. What is the midpoint of PQ? O is the midpoint of PQ. So you can say that now 2, -3 is equal to x1 + 1/2, y1 + y2/2. So you can simply do this. x1 + 2 is equal to 2, y1 + 4/2 is equal to -3. So x1 + 1 is equal to 4, x1 is equal to 3. So y1 + 4 is equal to -6, y1 is equal to -10. Yes, sir, -10, 3, -10. Option A is correct. Look at this. Any doubts, children? Any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So, yes. So, this is the class of today, guys. So, you can just go through this recording lecture. If you want, you can just go through the class notes as well. So we'll meet in the next session. Until then, goodbye. Thank you. And children, look at this here. Tomorrow probably, So if you need, I'll be taking an extra class tomorrow. So I'll be posting the names. If I post the names, you'll be having the names, like whomever them names I'm giving you in the group, those students has to be joined. So if I'm not posting, then which means you don't have class. All right. So if I post the names, you must join tomorrow. Yes, I'll tell the timings, including everything. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.